risk. Sign up today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi everyone, Basil Chapman on this 29th day of July, just about to wrap up the month of July. Oh, I keep saying that each month. It goes so quickly. Well, we're looking at the Dow. Up 76, it's been impacted by Boeing. Boeing is down 5.30 at 165.56. Gone underneath that rectangle. Remember, rectangle formation can last a lot longer than your patience. Every time it gets to the support level, you think, aha, now it's going to break down. Instead, it turns up and it goes to the resistance. Every time it goes to the upper part of the band of the rectangle, you think it's going to break out. Aha, but it turns around and comes back in. Except this time, we've closed underneath. If you think of this like the dreaded H, we've got a day, at least we've got, give it 2 days in which to break, to close above. It's at 165.42 right now. It needs to break above close above 166.01. That was the left side low back in June. And we'll see what happens there. It looks to me in the weekly chart that it keeps making these big spirals on news, and then it gives it all back, but it doesn't give back the full candle. So this is going to be one of those times that you're going to see if there's a test. But it is impacting the Dow. Dow is up 69. The S&P, slightly different chart pattern, is holding much better. It's up 24 at 32.42.56. It's walking both the 14 period and now the nine, the green nine. It'll take a lot for this green to go underneath the 14 period moving average. It would probably have to go to 31.90, close under 31.90. And we're at 32.42 right now. That's a big move, 50 points. Well, at this particular moment, what I am looking at is that the weekly chart is making a doji-type candle from last week going with a no new high this week. Cannot go above 3279.99. That makes a peak D. If it closes in the lower range, if it closes more towards 3200, then 3255, 3260, then I think they'll be going to see a week following week, the first week of August. Meantime, back at the ranch, what we are looking at is the QQQs, and of course they're at Congress, some of the biggies, four of them are there. You know, all I can say is that it's a spectacular move. You've got a mini down channel, a very wide channel, from the high of 269.79 on the 13th, comes down to a low of 252.76 a day later, goes up for about six sessions, and it hits the 268.41 level on the 21st, which creates a downtrend line. Let me just draw that in. I'm not going to do anything fancy there, just a downtrend line. And if you do a parallel line, it happens to coincide exactly with a 252.76 low, and 4 days ago, the low of 251.32. And there you've got your channel. So now what I normally would do is I'd say, okay, you're in a channel. This is going to be pink, because if you go under it, it's going to be very close under it. It's going to be very negative. If you close just above it, you're inside the ChapmanWave buy zone, and that's positive, and you can rebound from that level to this trend line resistance. If it takes out this trend line support of 256.50, that then becomes a resistance level. And on the upside, I'm not going to get too carried away. I'm not going to change the colors just yet. I am going to say that there's an inside repellent line being built, and that goes between, I'll tell you where it is. It's between 263.30, and a breakout would be above 266.50. So those are your parameters, but we've got one dreaded H, which has gone below the left side low and then bounced above it, which is good. Then it gave it back yesterday, a chunk of it, and now it's trying to rally towards the top part of it. All I can say is that the MACD is very negative. Stochastic is negative at 35%. On balance, volume is not bad. The relative strength is okay at about 67%. And what we are looking at is that, I said I'd do this. Let me see if I can use this one. Give me a second. I'm going to go right here. This is the one I use for the Chapman Wave Right here, let's go. Come on, there we are. So if I use this particular chart right here for the QQQ, let me show you something. I'm going to expand this out, expand. You can see that the green line, it's always embarrassing to see this. From April, well, April the 4th, we were long on, at the turn on the 23rd of March. The options then on the April the 4th, at just under 21,000, we went long the Dow. But look, if you went long on the 7th, no, it was, really, yeah, the 7th, when it actually crossed positive, the 9 period over the green over the black. Let's just say you got in at about right there. At 200, let's just make a round number, 200. If you based a technique, and I had a whole webinar on this, on just this one technique, well, of course, it doesn't work every time, but when it works, it's magnificent. You would be in to this day at 258, 25% or more gain. And what's really important about it is that if it if everything goes right this week and all of a sudden the QQQs, instead of being at 255, they're actually at 261. Right somewhere over here, 261, 262. That green line will expand once again instead of crossing negative. You'd still be in. So based on that, I'm anticipating that we are going to have some choppiness here, that we could have a bit of a pullback. A retest of the low was made to 251.32 back on the 24th, 4 days ago. But that's anticipating something. That's using other techniques, not this technique. This technique says hold tight. You're still looking good, even though it's narrow. This is the narrowest it's been above the black. The 14-period moving average above the 9-period green one is above the 14, but just barely. I'll give you the parameters. Let me see if I've got it now. So where we are right here. So it says 259.18 is above 258.66. 50 cents makes a difference. So that's why I think this is a very important period. All right, enough with that. We've discussed this. And now let's go to the IWM. Look at the IWM. Very nice. Wrong chart. Let's get the IWM right here. IWM is trading right now. If I can click on one there, there it is. IWM is up at 148.30, up 2.15. Nice action, really nice action. And it's a high-level consolidation. The weekly chart could very well be saying to us that out of the four indices that I've just discussed, the IWM, the Russell 2000, is finding a little bit more support than the others right now. That's important. It's in the rectangle formation, moving more towards the top than the bottom. All right, now let's go to gold. Gold is up almost 10 at 1973.7. Very, very good action. I know there's been a lot of talk about a gold pullback, a silver pullback. I'm just saying to you this. The MACD is just, it hasn't yet even tilted down yet. It's still expanding. The stochastic is flat at 90. That's very good. On balance, one in the, what I call the, this is the one time I use the word overbought, because this is where it starts to look like it could turn, have a sudden pullback. But the price and the 9 period over the 14 period, this is magnificent action. So gold is holding very well. And if you want to do this real quickly before we go to the break, the dollar is again down. It's down 29 cents at 93.40. Whoa, not good. I'll be back in a moment with this leg after the downside.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hi, everyone. So using that same methodology I was just discussing before, look, here's a peak D in the 2-minute chart of the E-mini at 32, I think that's 38, yep, 32-38. And it pulls back. It happened to be a peak F in the 5 minutes. You can see just that I was doing this before my show started. I usually do that live. And then this is a peak F in the 10-minute. But this is going to be the issue right now. Just the thing about it. The question was, this is a good question. Duffy asked, gold holding well, but GDX is down. Does the GDX need gold? Well, very often it does turn out that the miners are just like I said in the answer back was the miners are a little bit more sensitive to the whims and fancies of the gold market. Actually, it's a great den. I mean, we have wonderful people there. He has a good one. I missed the M when I was typing. I'm not a great typer. So I said a little ore sensitive. And then Robert says, I love it, Basil, are ore sensitive. Nice Freudian slip, the miners. Yeah. So... all right. So in the meantime, let me tell you what I've got. In the ChapmanWave methodology, I'll have to do this because we always have new listeners. Let me just tell you exactly what I'm going to be talking about right now. Let me move this across. You know, for those of you who know my work, you know exactly where I'm coming from. But let's just do this. In the ChapmanWave methodology, we try to identify the lowest low bar. You can see the up arrow there. You can see the up arrow there. Sometimes it's really obvious. Sometimes you have to do a little homework to actually pick the right level of starting point. And then you count each successively higher peak. And I alphabetize them, uppercase on the way up, lowercase on the way down. But it's on the way up that the fourth highest peak, peak A, B, C, D, that fourth highest peak is where other things can happen. It can go to E, F, and G. That's 5, 6, 7. But it's really at D that other things can happen. That's where you lift your foot off the accelerator, hover over the brake, because that's where you can have quite a deep decline. But at the same time, you want to keep your options open. And for that, you use other techniques. So this is what happened here. In the GDX, you got a low at a trough D and went to peak A, B, C, D. And that was a cup, ChapmanWave cup and ladle, because it broke out to D above the left side high. And what happens in that instance is it almost always goes to either a D, E, or F, and that certainly from D, you expect some kind of a pullback, and then you use the left side high, this is the GDX, as your your base of support if you're going to go higher. It'll break down below it if it's starting to digest gains. But that Chapman Wave cup and ladle breakout is just a fantastic weapon in your arsenal to have. And at 37.49 on the 19th, look what happened. We pulled back off the peak D. We pulled back to 36.87 and then went right back on its way. And you can see the MACD did not cross negative. Instead, it just continued up. And all I do usually in that case, and this is a Chapman Wave instant restart, I automatically go sequentially high, EF. But when you get to F, you watch out, because if you get a turn down in the unbalanced volume, which we just had, and the stochastic is strong and it has gone from flat to declining, that's when you say, uh-oh, now there could be a pullback. Where to? And then you start looking at moving averages, gaps, there's a fuller gap, troughs on the left side. But if it's flat and 87% and not really turning down, you've got to say, wait a minute, the 9 period is way above the 14 period moving average. Is at 41.71 as opposed to 40.79. So those are key supports. But to get this, to really get a down arrow into a sell mode on the GDX, you would have to see a close way below 39.60. And now probably you'd have to go lower or take a little more time. So it's either going to be a sharp, vicious turnaround of the dollar going up and gold going down. But in the meantime, I'm respecting this peak F at 44.46 3 days ago. And if it breaks above that, I'll have to say maybe that's a recycle or a G. I'd have to do an analysis. But I am saying to you, the weekly chart in leg E could also have an instant restart. But that E with the stochastic at 94% and the MACD very strong, you can see the relative strength. It's just turned red right there. It means it's a little toppy, but it's very strong at about 75%. So I'm saying to you, I would rather think of gold having a bit of a pullback. I said to subscribers to my opening call the other day, I put in gold getting a little choppy right here. Would we want to, let's use the DZZ as an instrument to check. I don't want to be short an instrument that's leading the way in psychologically, physically, economically, sector-wise, in every single case. I, you could get a real quick pullback, and that would have been great. Look, the DZZ, when I mentioned it, it was trading at the 250 area. No, it was less than that. 253 was the low yesterday. And look, 253 to 287, that is a fabulous percentage gain. That's the two, is that two times? Yeah, double short the gold. You have to be perfect on this one. I just want to use it as an indicator, because if it happens to hold and then goes to 2.92, somewhere around there, I'd say, yes, now gold is starting to pull back. So I just wanted to mention some of the techniques you can use. So this is the GDX. This is GD. I hit by mistake. General Dynamics. Hey, holding quite well. GDX. GDX is down $1 at 42.55. I could fill the gap and start testing these moving averages. I would prefer to go step by step here. And why? Because look, silver, which was the laggard, and now silver is, look at this parameter. It has a high of 26. I forgot to type that in, 26.275 yesterday, and a low of 22.46. That, the distance between intraday high and low yesterday, this is not even with the futures. This is the price. I'll include it as this is the price itself. That level of 4 points, you can see 4 points from 21. You'd have to go back to the low of 20 right there on the 21st of July to see a move like that. And that took 3 bars. So, silver's in a rectangle. It's going to go sideways. In fact, I'll do what I do with Boeing. I'm going to make a little inside rectangle, and let's see what happens. If it closes above 25, it could work its way a little higher, close that is, and if it pulls back and goes underneath 23, probably it's going to go towards the lower range. And just make it as simple as you can. But look at this, the dollar, my dollar, because we've been long since 90.07, rode it all the way to 102.99, discussed it as if to say, is this going to turn into a single leg A to the upside? Well, it did. It was an E in the monthly, and we've given back all the gains. Look, there's the candle that we just saw in silver. Look at this. That long, it happens to be a monthly candle, not a daily candle. And then it just took out. It tried to rally, failed. And once it took out key support at about 97, it was just lights out, and it's down, down, down. It's down 28 cents today at 93.42. I have to put this as an F/B because it could have recycled to the downside. Ay, ay, ay. I'm holding it. The only reason why we're holding it, we have taken a little bit off in the 96s, but the only reason why I'm holding it is that I thought it would become an icon of the U.S. economy. If we start to come back in another couple of months, and that it should have held the 95 to 94 area, but it's gone lower than that. It's in the 93s. So that says to me, wrong thinking, mister. But anyway, we're still holding it. We'll see what happens. I'll be back in a moment. I'm up to the dollar, right? I have to look at the TLT. The TLT is down a little bit, down 70 cents. We'll talk about the rates. And then I'll get to question about Bitcoin. I got a whole bunch. I got a list of questions. Bitcoin was in amongst them. I'll be there in a moment. Basil Chapman, Tiger Newsons Hour, Dow's up 97.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, an essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that we'll even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
The question I had the other day, we were talking about the market. Perhaps this is a harbinger that we're not coming back in economically soon. And I said, well, at least in my history and reading history, to not have a major market top without the brokers and financial having a blow-off top and every single person on earth talking about how much money they've made in the stock market, I just, that would be what I call a historic counterpunch. One of the biggest I've ever seen in the stock market, because even 2008, 2009 financials, 1987 financials, 2000 financials, they were always there, and they're always the culprits of allowing money to be loaned and borrowed that shouldn't have been. And that's number one. Number two is, I said, if that's the case, you're going to have to use a new term in looking out in the future, and that's getting COVID-ed. Because, that would be so unusual. Now, it can happen, but it's usually, I'm considering that the mega bull market was kind of abducted. It was aborted in February. It was interrupted, and that it should still come back. I will see. I mean, could be totally wrong, but that's still my thinking. All right, so a couple of things that I was asked to look at, but I'll first go TLT. Yeah, it's at the top. Look, I mentioned this before, that H pattern goes to a lowercase m pattern in the weekly chart. We're right there at 169. If you start to see this at 175 and the market does pull back, I'm not expecting any major pullbacks right now. I do think that we're going to have a consolidation in certain sectors. And I still think the tech sector is kind of vulnerable right now. It doesn't mean to say it has to smash to the downside, but it does say that it could struggle, make slightly lower highs and lower lows. We'll see. Okay. Now, what I wanted to do is this. I wanted to show you something that I thought was quite important. Just let me finish this. The DXY is now down below this long-term trend line. Well, the month is not finished, but it's below it at 93.45. It's really just an ugly pattern. And yes, you're getting at 5% in the stochastic, you're getting very overbought. Overbought doesn't mean to say, that's the wrong term, oversold, sorry. Oversold, it's not oversold, it's in oversold territory, that's all. All right? And the MACD is still increasing the negativity, so it's going to take a little while. Even if it bounces, it's going to have to do some retesting. So sound back, what happened? Sound, okay. All right. So let me just do this. The questions that I had pertain to the GBTC. Pulling back today, 1260, this is the Bitcoin, it's called Grayscale Bitcoin Trust, and it's trading at 1260, up 7 cents, but it's up 7 cents with a red candle because it's struggling a little bit. I think it's in play. And it's part of that whole gold thing, but you've got to think of it very differently. You have to think of it as the gold had some other aspect. It was not just, I call it a currency of fear, but it was more than that. It was a full sector mega bull rally. And that is now transmitted in the little baby cousin trying to pick up some steam, and that's Bitcoin, saying, hey, if you're a fear factor, why aren't we a fear factor? We are a fear factor because we are part of the currency thing. You know, this whole currency thing, dollars going to hell in the handbasket or whatever the expression is. No, I think this is a really good bounce. But if you look at the monthly chart, it is part of the rectangle formation. It's trading between about the 16s and the 7s. And it's on the way up towards testing the high that was made at about 13.80, maybe touching 14, as it moves higher. This is a very strong leg B. It did close above the high of the 10th of June at 12.56 was the high, and this close yesterday was at 12.53. Okay, it hasn't quite closed there. But what even more important than that is that I'm looking at it and saying, it is in play. And that's really what I had said even about a week or so ago when it suddenly bounced to 1050. I said, I think it's now more in play. I don't know. I didn't expect it to gap up as much as it did, but it is in play. And I would just say to you, it's in a leg D in the weekly. Does it have to make a leg C and a D? Well, the MACD and stochastic are strong enough that it should. So I would put it this way. If you can see a pullback between 12.10, I think that was the question, where would you get in? Between 12.10 and 11.80, I'd start a position if you haven't got in already. Certainly, we haven't for my opening call subscribers. We have an alternate count, an alternate sector that we're looking at. That it looks to me like it is in play. It looks like if it is a D, it's underneath the previous peak C minus. So that's just saying it's kind of stuck in a range. It's now becoming a very wide range and a very wide percentage range. But if you look at it historically, it's really just a small little range because it once in 38.71 and then it dropped to 366. So I would just put this in the middle of the lower range. Okay, next question I had was, let's see. Yeah, I'm not sure where that's coming from in the den, but I'm steady here. I'm just doing what I'm doing. My technicals so far today are good. Okay, here we go. A question I had, let me just go through the questions. GBTC, that was the first one, and then you asked in the den, so that's the question I've answered there. GE, you know, I don't see anything. Oh, look at that. GE is down 33 at 6.57. I've been saying for a while, if everything that Culper, what was the guy's name? Whatever his name is, the new CEO, he's not so new anymore. Whatever he's doing, if it hasn't worked yet, I think GE's have got a real problem. And I suspect that they're still in the wrong sectors because they're also selling some stuff that I wouldn't be surprised if you look back. They didn't really want to sell because it was the best of what they had, but they just had to raise money so they had to get the best prices. So I think it's still kind of stuck. GE is just stuck. I suspect GE will be in play, but much later on. There's a lot of homework to really get done. Maybe the final quarter. So wait, was there a little sound problem? Let's see. I don't see anything. Oh, we got Mark at Fort Collins. Mark, how are you?
Good, Basil. How are you?
I'm good. You would like to look at?
So I'm in CX from 282.
Nice.
And I wanted to get your thoughts.
Okay. So did I not mention it today? I think I did. Did I mention it? Oh, I didn't mention it. What's today? Wednesday? Did I mention it yesterday? I thought I mentioned it in my newsletter.
Yeah, I've seen it in the newsletter, and that's kind of what got me to buy it.
Okay,
I just have been, been holding on to it for a little bit.
So this is very interesting because it was off my radar as a screamer. I've had it before as a screamer. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. But the reason is, it was in this rectangle formation and it was going to the lower range. And the candles that I was looking at, these three little small candles, were saying to me, just for the moment, it's probably stuck in this narrow range. And the narrow range I'm drawing right now would be like this between, let's say, 295 and between 295 and 273-ish. And then all of a sudden, there was this really good candle, and you probably got it the day before, this candle of the 27th of July, where it shot up to 317, and then yesterday it went even higher. And I'm looking at this, and I'm saying, wow, it is back in play. And this is part of the rotation into cyclical-type stocks, infrastructure, let's say. I'll be right back with Mark in a moment. We're up.
The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The gold report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The gold report is a comprehensive look at the metal sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the gold report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the gold report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-Share Bull and Bear ETFs. China A-Shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-4000. 7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
So we're on with Mark and Fort Collins. We're looking at CMEX, SA. It's a Mexican cement company. Actually, I believe they do a ton of work in the U.S. I haven't checked lately, but they had. You know, Mark, I think at the price that you got in, I know this is a little different to what I would normally do. I'm just thinking this is one of those stocks that it started very significantly to make higher highs and higher lows. The fact that it just popped up into the 314, 318 area, I'm just thinking that this is one that I would probably say to you, let's try this time not to do any trading. I don't know if this fits your thinking. You're in a 280-something. It's trading at 312. Are you able to treat that as a first position and that the stop that you would have had the day that you put it on, at that stop, I don't know what if you made it 10 cents or 15 or 20, whatever it is, whatever the stop is, I would then think about adding a second position and try to see, because this is rising. It's not falling. It's making, it does take back a lot of percentage gains, but it's making a stair-step move to the upside. And I should have done that, but I'm not prepared to sit there with a 15% loss for subscribers. I'm at a very small loss. We're out. We're done. We can always come back. But if you think that you're prepared to, if you agree with me that now that it's touched the 200-day moving average in the daily of 308 and it's closed three times, well, we don't know about today, but so far it looks like it's going to close three times above it, that's already turning the 297, 292 area into very strong support, unless the general market just really rips to the downside. So I kind of like this. I mean, if I you want, yeah, does that fit your thinking?
Yeah, that is. I mean, I was just curious as if you had like an upside target and a stop. I'm comfortable with that.
I do have an upside target of 341. The black 14-period moving average in the monthly chart, because this is the first month that the MACD has closed together with a rising stochastic in the monthly chart. I think this is a turn that could be a turn of significance. But in this particular market, I mean, I don't know what's going to happen next if there's, you know, bad news or whatever. But just looking at the chart, I kind of like what I see. That's all I'm saying to you. And I don't know if you want to go in and out. Yeah, you can make money, but the real money is if you're able to pick these very low price stocks and really hold them into the double digits from a single digit. That's, you know what I'm saying? And this might be the opportunity. And if you miss the opportunity and you know what your risk is, I'm prepared. I'm just saying to you, you know what? Today is Wednesday. Friday or Monday, we'll look at it again. But I'm suspecting that this is starting to build a rising base, unless something really happens to the market that's really bad. But so far, this is the first time it's tackling the down, the major monthly down channel. Look at this, green and red. I made it as thick as I could, going from the 1037 high of back in 2017 down to the $1.55 low of, I think, what it was, January or so, February. And now look at it. It's starting to pull very nicely. That could fail, but this is the first time it's tackling very significantly with all the guns out. Look, the MACD's turning up, W formation. I love that. If it fails, it fails, but this is the opportunity. So I'm just saying to you, I like it very much. If you're looking for a long-term position and you're prepared to say, look, I've got a real good gain, I don't want to give up that gain, but this action is very good. And if it comes back towards my entry price, I'd rather be thinking of adding than going in and out and in and out. That's kind of my thinking. That's all.
Okay, that's helpful. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for calling, and I'm going to keep my eye on the CX, folks, trading at 3.12, up 3 cents. Now, before we get a wrap-up, we have one more section to go. I want to do a couple of things. Let's see, there's a question there, question there, question there. Yeah, so before we go to this particular break, I had a question about jets. So look at this. This is jets. This is the ETF of the airlines. It's trading at 15.83. It's down 23 cents at 1583. And then yesterday I mentioned, look, JetBlue is the – I mean, if I look at this left side chart, you can look at the right side or the left side, they look the same, JetBlue. So keep – if you want to know what the overall airline sector is doing, I think as far as the ETF is concerned, jets is fine. But JetBlue, which is – I haven't been on JetBlue for a long time, but – it's one of the better companies for sure, just in terms of comfort and everything there. And for passengers, at least that's my experience of speaking to a lot of people. So I'm just saying, keep your eye on JetBlue. If it starts to move from the 992 area in the next month and a half, suddenly you're looking at it at 12, and coincidentally, Jets is moving up, and Jets has gone from 1583 to 17.82. That's going to be what the sign that you're looking for. And then IYT, which has transports as well, just today made leg D. Remember, we were looking at this left side price time match. It failed to get there. That was yesterday, would have been a good place. So today it went to 176.57. It's at 174.53 right now, up 2.83. And this is the better part of the rectangle formation when it looks more like the U. And look, there it is. So I like what I'm seeing. And it might be the trucking. Isn't Y trucker? Let me just have a look. Okay, Y. Is that Allegheny or something? Allegheny? Wait, is this a trucker or not? I can't remember. Y Daily? All right, well, I don't remember what that trucker is. But in the meantime, back at the ranch, we are looking at CSX, the rails, trying to rally. Not bad. It's in the upper part of its half, upper part of its 80 to 46 smash back in March. Now it bounced all the way to 76, and now it's trading at 71. So it's working hard, but it's not great. So it needs to use this ChapmanWave inside track repellent zone for CSX rails. It needs to climb above 70. It needs to get, it's at 71.34. In the next 3 weeks, you need to see it not below 68, but above the high that was made right there on the 5th of June, the week of the 5th of June, 76.9, let's say 77s. If it can do that, I think we're starting to turn the corner, and that's going to be really important. Quick question about Tesla. Tesla is holding nicely, but it's stuck in that range. Look at the number of charts that have made this pattern the ChapmanWave at dreaded H. You've got Tesla, you've got Apple. It actually broke the left side. Now it's come back again. It is up 4.38 today, 377. Amazon comes out with earnings tomorrow. We'll discuss that in greater detail tomorrow. Look, there's the same pattern. They stuck. They've had a fantastic move. So unless Amazon comes out with an outlook, not what's been, what's coming on, and saying, look, the outlook is that we're going to have a really good, what would it be, third quarter. I think, I don't know, would it be the fourth quarter? Wait, what is the second? Yeah, the third quarter. So I think that these things are stuck. They're digesting huge gains. That's the reason why I think the QQQs Right now, I'm stuck a little bit. What's LB is the lingerie company, right? LB is, what are they called? L Brands, yeah. Look at that. You see, that's the monthly. That's what you want to see. If Mark's listening, that's exactly what you want to see in the monthly. All of a sudden, there's this break to the upside, a big candle in the monthly chart after being just horrible. Well, this is a leg C.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by, bam! As well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and to help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionics, oil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. This is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge heard here at TFNN.com.
Just before we wrap up the section, so the question again about what our positions. Now, we have today, for instance, we have one stock up, 3.9%, another stock up 0.64%, another one up 1.46%. Another one that we got stopped out of, unfortunately, just got stopped out of, and I've liked it. I'm upset that we were stopped out of it, although I think we will get another entry point, is actually up 2.2%. So I can't complain. And the QQQ that we actually shorted at the close, as it ratted right into the close on Monday, had a really sharp pullback, and I'm going to tighten up the stop. It was more an experiment to see how we will deal when we finally get to that peak D in the weekly chart of the QQQs. That's when I want to practice so that we're not afraid to go short if that's what is applicable. I don't know yet, but we've got a small short in the meantime. That's the only short we have. So, yes, TGB is pulling back. That is, Taseko Mines made a fantastic move to the 86 area, 0.86, it's down at 0.63. I think have a little patience after such a big move, maybe in the 0.57 to 0.53 area. That's maybe where you want to look at it again. question about Nat. I'm really upset. This was actually on my buy list that I wanted. I forgot to read my notes that NAT would have been a buy today for my, as a screamer. It's up 2.97. It's at 4.50. I discussed this, I think, yesterday or the day before, Nordic at American Tankers Shipping. Nice move up today. It's up 0.13 at 4.50. I don't know if it's going to keep going, but I just wanted this move that looked like it could bounce today, and it did. Sorry, folks. My mistake. Facebook, what about Facebook? Can I show the chart? Yep. Facebook's got that arch formation. Looks to me like peak D in the weekly. Very quick. Peak A to B to C to D. Always says, watch out, you've got a pullback. Not a major decline, but a sharp pullback coming. That's exactly what we've got here. Let's see if it can hold at 231. It better hold 225 next week, otherwise that's a problem. But so far, look at and Tesla about to, on Friday. I'll do Tesla again tomorrow. I think Tesla has a chance to maybe have a little pop-up either Thursday afternoon or Friday morning. I'll discuss it tomorrow. I think you've got time. Have a little patience. You want the best price you can get if you're dealing with options. Hey, have a great day. Stay tuned for Steve, Dave, and Tom. I'll be back tomorrow. Check out my opening call, my daily newsletter.